In this video, we will show you how to prepare and administer TPN at home. First, gather your TPN supplies on a clean surface. Here is a list of everything you are going to need. Use your TPN preparation mat to help stay organized. Check your TPN bag and labels to make sure your name is on it and that the other information listed is correct. Sanitize your work area and wash your hands thoroughly for at least 30 seconds. A clean work surface and clean hands are crucial to avoid infection. Just a reminder, always allow your TPN bag to reach room temperature by removing the TPN from the refrigerator 2 to 3 hours prior to your next TPN cycle. Never try to warm the bag up faster in any way. Remove the supplies from the packaging and lay them out according to the pictures on the TPN mat. Make sure to remove the paper wrapping off the IV tubing and remove the breakaway tab off the yellow flow stop on the IV tubing. Remove the caps from both vials. Clean the tops of the vials for 15 seconds with an alcohol pad. Use a separate alcohol pad for each vial. Allow the vials to air dry for 10 seconds. Remove the seal from the injection port of the TPN bag. And, with a new alcohol pad, clean the injection port. Make sure you don't touch it with your fingers or let it touch any surface after it's cleaned. Make sure the ports of the bag hang off the table when placing it onto your work surface. Now it's time to prepare your TPN bag. Draw air into the syringe by pulling the plunger. Remove the cap from the needle. With the first vial on the table, insert the syringe into the vial. Then, turn the syringe and vial upside down and push the air into the vial. Next, draw out the medication in the prescribed amount. Repeat the same steps with the first vial of pushing air into the vial upside down and drawing the medication out from the second vial. Remove the syringe from the second vial and, while keeping the needle tip facing up, tap the syringe and then push the plunger to expel any air. Insert the needle into the center of the injection port of the TPN bag and inject the medication. Repeat the same instructions for any additional additives. Use the scoop method to recap the needle. Once the needle is capped, unscrew it from the plastic syringe. Discard the syringe in the trash and the needle in a sharps container. With the TPN bag still lying on the mat, gently massage the bag a few times to mix the medication. Then, twist the cap off the spike port of the TPN bag. If your TPN bag does not already come with the IV tubing pre-attached, remove the cap from the spike end of the tubing. Insert the spike tip into the center port of the TPN bag using a pushing and twisting motion until you reach the stop. Be careful not to touch the spike tip or the spike port, as this can cause infection. We will show you two ways to prime your tubing. The first way is to prime manually. To prime the tubing manually, complete the following steps. Place the bag on the TPN pole, letting the IV tubing hang below the bag. Remove the cap from the other end of the IV tubing. Hold the filter so that the flow is downward. This will allow the fluid to fill the filter properly. Squeeze the yellow stop flow tab lever to let the fluid flow through the tubing until you see a few drops come out the other end. Make sure there are no air bubbles trapped in the tubing before continuing. Changing the batteries on the pump. Locate the battery cover on the back of the pump. Open the cover by sliding the bar right to the unlock position. Remove the battery cover by sliding the cover downward. Insert the two new C batteries so that they are in the same upright position. Slide the cover back on the pump and lock it by sliding the gray bar to the left lock position. Now it's time to connect the IV tubing to the curlin pump. find the door on the top of the pump. Pull the latch up and open the door. If you haven't already, remove the breakaway tab from the yellow flow stop on the IV tubing. Next, insert the blue guide pin in the slot indicated by the blue arrow on the right side of the pump. Make sure the tubing is in the front of the door hinge and rested into the notch. This will ensure that the tube will not be pinched or ruptured. Stretch the tubing across the top of the pump, aligning it in the tubing track. Find the yellow arrow on the left side of the pump and insert the yellow flow stop into the nearby slot. Close the door and the latch, making sure the tube is not being pinched. Next, turn on the pump by pressing the on-off key. You will hear a series of three beeps and self-check screens will scroll through. The screen will now read Enter to select Program or Library. If Program is not highlighted, use the up-down arrows to navigate. Press the Yes Enter key to select Program. Next, there will be two options, Repeat Rx or New Program. Press the Yes Enter key to select Repeat Rx. The display will automatically review your medication program, including medication type, interval, and dosing. The screen will automatically advance through the program. Once this is complete, you will see a menu with four options: Run to Start, No to Review, Options, or Prime. You will need to prime the tubing if you have not already done it manually. Please make sure your tubing is disconnected from your port during this process. Release any clamps on the IV tubing. Press the Prime Bolus key at the bottom right corner of the pump. A new menu will appear that says Hold Prime key and Yes to exit. Press and hold the Prime Bolus key for a few seconds until a small amount of solution oozes out and there are no air bubbles in the tubing. When you release the Prime key, the screen will ask you to press Yes to exit. Press the Yes Enter key to return to the previous menu. You are now ready to flush your IV catheter with the saline solution. First, wash your hands or use an alcohol-based hand sanitizer. Remove the cap from one of the saline syringes. With the tip pointed upwards, push the plunger to expel any air. Then, clean your injection cap with an alcohol pad for 30 seconds and let air dry for 10 seconds. Attach the syringe to your IV catheter by pushing and twisting the syringe clockwise. Then, open the clamp on your catheter. Flush your IV catheter with saline using the push-pause method until your IV catheter is completely flushed, or as otherwise instructed by your nurse. Remove the syringe and discard it in the trash. Now you are ready to infuse the TPN. Scrub the injection cap of your injection port with an alcohol pad vigorously for 30 seconds. Let air dry for 10 seconds. Remove the cap from your IV tubing and connect it to your injection port using a pushing and twisting motion. Once the tubing is connected to the central line, press the Run Pause key. You'll know when the process has started when the green light by Run starts blinking. When pressing pause, a yellow standby indicator will be turned on, and three options will appear on the display: Resume, Repeat Rx, and New Program. By default, Resume is selected. You can resume the infusion by pressing the Yes key, then Run. With a TPN backpack, you are free to be as active as you like throughout the duration of your infusion. Your pump will alert you once your TPN infusion process is complete. After receiving the alert, turn off the infusion by pressing Run Pause, then On Off. Prep the flushes and alcohol pads before disconnecting the IV tubing from your IV catheter. Disconnect the IV tubing from your IV catheter. Scrub the IV cap with alcohol for at least 15 seconds. Post-flush your line using saline with the push-pause method. use another alcohol wipe to scrub the IV cap again before flushing with heparin using the push-pause method. Make sure to remove the caps and push the air out before connecting your IV catheter. Reclamp your central line and peel off the seal from the green Kuros cap to the prep cap. Scrub the IV cap with an alcohol pad before attaching the green Kuros cap to the end of your IV catheter. Don't disconnect the tubing from the TPN bag. Remove the TPN bag and the tubing from the pump and dispose of them in the trash or as otherwise instructed by your nurse. Seek medical attention if you experience any of the following. Have a question about any of these steps? Reach out to AmeriPharma TPN clinicians for further guidance. We are happy to help you in any way possible.